व्यासं प्रतायकर्तृभ्यो षर्षिभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्रवरहितः प्रज्ञानकरः प्रत्यग्रो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि। नारायणं पद्मभुवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दयोगिनमथासि शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यपद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तन्तोटकं वार्तिकारमन्यानस्मद्गुरुं सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु, सहनौ भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मदीजनितसौख्यमभूज्ज तस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहि च कृष्णमहं नमामि। यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽपि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकचाङ्कमनन्तसुखाकृतिम्। So having looked at all the darshanikas also agreeing with the adhyasa lakshana, basic adhyasa lakshana, now the purva pakshi asks as to adhyasa as explained is fine in the case of rajju sarpa or shuktika rajata. In the Pratibhasika Sthala, it is fine. But how do you extend it to Atma and talk about Ahankara Adhyasa? That doesn't seem possible. Although all the Darshanikas may agree with Paratra Avabhasa, Paratra Paravabhasa. And they may validate your example. There I have no objections, but in the case of Ahankara Adhyasa, how is it possible? So the question is, katham punaha pratyagatmani avishaye adhyaso vishayatad dharmanam. The adhyasa is tadatmya sambandha of the dharmi, and then there is adhyasa of dharmas also. This is what you meant. And in the exemplified atma, which is not avishaya. So katham punaha, how is it possible that pratyagatmani avishaye adhyasaha? So the adhyasa of anatma on atma may seem possible to you, but to me it is asambhava. Why? Because atma is avishaya. Your example is of vishaya, whereas Atma is avishaya. It cannot become adhisthana, because even to become an adhisthana of adhyasa, it should be a vishaya first. Therefore, the innermost self not being vishaya, there is no possibility of adhyasa. And since tadatmya sambandha dharmi adhyasa is not possible, dharma adhyasa bahuduram. It is not possible. Vishaya, Vishaya and Vishaya is anatma here, and Vishaya dharmana, tad dharmana madhyasa. So both the dharmi adhyasa and dharma adhyasa are not possible. Why so? Sarvohi puravasthita eva vishaye vishayantaram adhyasyati. Further, Purapakshi explains that if this is not clear, he says everyone who has an adhyasa, what is their anubhava? The anubhava is that there is an adhyasa. This anubhava is after the adhyasa goes away. Knowing the rajju as rajju, one knows that sarpa was superimposed by me on this rajju, which is visible in the front of my eyes. So each and everyone, sarvahi, all meaning each and everyone, in every case of adhyasa, each person superimposes something on what is available in the front. So sarvohi puraha avasthitaha. Pura avasthita is pura avastha, that which is placed in front. Pratyaksha pramana siddha, right in front of your eyes, there itself eva vishaye, that is a vishaya. You are looking at a pratyaksha vishaya, and on that, missing that pratyaksha vishaya, you have superimposed something else. Vishayantaram anya vishaya, another vishaya is superimposes adhyasthiti. So everyone superimposes one vishaya on another vishaya. That another vishaya on which the superimposition takes place is also vishaya. It is also an object, object of cognition. Now atma has to be an object of cognition first in a similar manner, then only you can have adhyasa. And that is explained further by the Purvapakshi as Yushmat Pratya Upetasya Cha Pratyagatmanaha Avishyatvam Bravishi. And you, the Siddhanti, talks about Atma, which is Pratyagatma, the innermost self, Asmat Pratya Gochara. So Yushmat Pratya Upetasya Cha, that which is different from this Yushmat Pratya. Yushmat Pratyay Gochara is Anatma, whereas Asmat Pratyay Gochara you have spent a lot of time explaining as that is Atma. And Anatma can be an object, but Atma cannot be an object. So Yushmat Pratyay Upetasya, which is different and which is beyond the objectification, as Yushmat Pratyaya, that kind of a Pratyagatma of that Tasya Cha Pratyagatmana, which is what? Tasya is Yushmat Pratyaya Upetasya. So what is Yushmat Pratyaya Upeta, which is beyond the Yushmat Pratyaya kind of a category, which is beyond the category of an object, which is not in the category of an object of anatma and therefore not an object. That kind of pratyagatma is what you are considering to be the adhisthana, which is what? Avishaya. You yourself mention avishyatvam bravishi tasya pratyagatmanaha. So the answer follows later, but let's look at vyakhya now. So Purvapakshi's intention is bhavatu adhyasaha shuktyadu. In the case of Shukti Rajata, there can be an adhyasa, and let it be, I agree. Bhavatu. Atmani tu na sambhavati. In Atma, however, that kind of an adhyasa is not possible. Iti akshepati. This is the akshepa by the Purvapakshi, katam punariti. Yatra aparoksha adhyasa adhishthanatvam, tatra indriya sanyuktatvam, vishayatvam cha iti vyapti shuktyadu drushta. Now take an example case to understand this vyapti. He says that there is no such vyapti in your exemplified case. In the case of example, it is possible. So just saying it is impossible is not right. You have to explain logically as to what is lacking in the exemplified, whereby I cannot extend the example to the exemplified. You have to show me the dosha. Otherwise, I can use an example, and unless there is an objection which can be proven, the exemplified will stand established. So Tarkika's approach is what? Some example has to be given, and this is similar. You show some vyapti and then you show similarity and extend it to the exemplified, unless there is an objection to the hetu given. Unless it is shown as asad hetu, the exemplified will also stand established like the example. And Purvapakshi has agreed to the example being proper. Now, what is the objection then? Why is it that I cannot extend it to the exemplified? In the Moola, it has been shown as avishyatvam is the hetu. However, when Vyapti is analyzed, the Vyapti given is Yatra Yatra Aparoksha Adhyasa Adhishthanatvam Shuktyadav Tatra Tatra Indriya Sanyuktatvam Vishayatvam Cha. Iti Vyapti. This is the Vyapti it is seen in Shuktyadi. Shukti and Rajju it is seen. Drishta. So is Shukti Aparoksha Adhyasa Adhishthana? It is. It is an adhishthana for adhyasa, that much we have seen. But is it aparoksha? It is definitely aparoksha, because aparoksha means pratyaksha. Somebody who is looking at Rajju Sarpa or Shukti Rajata, there the adhishthana is Shukti. Indriya Sannikarsha is there. So aparoksha adhyasa, when one is seeing Rajata, one sees Rajata as, oh, I am seeing it with my own eyes. This is the Aparoksha Anubhava. Therefore, Aparoksha Adhishthanatvam is there in Shukti. Tatra Tatra Indriya Sanyuktatvam. Indriya Sannikarsha is there, Indriya Sansanyoga. There is a connection of the Indriyas with the Shukti. Idanta Amsha, there is a connection. That one misses this Shukti, Shuktitva Amsha is a different story. But is there Indriya Sannikarsha? This is a Vyapti. Wherever there is Aparoksha Adhyasa Adhishthana, there Indriya Sannikarsha is there. What else is there? Vishayatvam Chai Iti. So it is an object of cognition. Because Indriya Sannikarsha is there, then what is Indriya cognizing? Indriya helping you cognize. It is helping you cognize a Vishaya, an object. Now this is the Vyapti. What does it mean? The converse corollary is what? Yatra yatra Indriya Sanyuktatva Bhavaha Vishayatva Bhavava Tatra Tatra Aparoksha Adhyasa Adhishthanatva Abhavaha. Wherever there is no Sannikarsha of Indriya, wherever there is no possibility of being an object, there Aparoksha Adhyasa Adhishthanatvam is not possible. It cannot be an Adhishthana for Aparoksha Adhyasa. Now take Atma. Is Atma a Vishaya? It is not a Vishaya. Is Atma known through Indriya Sannikarsha? It is not known. Then how can there be Aparoksha Adhyasa Adhishthanatvam in Atma, Pratyagatma? There is no possibility of Atma being Adhyasa Adhishthana. Therefore, Anatma cannot be superimposed on it. Anatma Dharmas cannot be superimposed on it. And your Asmat Pratyaya and Yushmat Pratyaya Gochara cannot be mixed up at all. Asambhava. This is the objection. Now, take another simpler example, which we all know. This stock example in Tarka is what? For Anumana, yatra yatra dhumaha tatra tatra vannihi. So there, vanni can be there without dhuma also. But the dhuma, not the chemical smoke, but smoke of the type of that, you know, that thick black kind of a smoke which comes out of fire, that kind of smoke cannot be there without fire being there. Therefore, yatra yatra dhumaha tatra tatra vannihi. Yatra yatra vannihi tatra tatra dhuma is not the right vyapti. Wherever there is fire, there need not be smoke. Like the iron rod which is heated up. So when you put iron rod in the fire, the iron rod will glow red, but there is no smoke there. But wherever there is a smoke, there has to be, wherever there is smoke, there has to be fire. Further what? The converse is also true. Yatra yatra dhuma bhavaha tatra tatra vanya bhavaha. Yatra yatha. The example case will be the water bodies. So whichever water body you take, a river or a lake, the river or lake cannot be having fire. The water cannot have fire. Therefore, wherever there is absence of smoke, So there, in the lake, there is no smoke and there is no fire also. So that also holds good. What does it mean is that there is a vyapya vyapaka sambandha between dhuma and agnihi. So the fire is in more places in comparison to the smoke. Smoke is in lesser places. Therefore, agnihi is vyapaka and dhuma is vyapya. So here, aparoksha adhyasa adhishthanattvam is vyapaka. And indriya sanyuktattvam vishayattvam, these are what? These are vyapyas. Our focus currently is on vishayattvam from mula. So what does it mean? Yatra yatra aparoksha adhyasa adhishthanattvam, wherever, meaning in so many places you have adhyasa adhishthanattvam, wherever you have, there you will have. So this is dhumasthaniya. So I said this is dhumasthaniya. So this is vyapya. I don't know what I said here. So this is vyapya, aparoksha. See, wherever there is indriya sannikarsha, there it is not adhyasa. Wherever there is vishayatvam, all those places don't have adhyasa. So vishayatvam and indriya sanyuktatvam, these are vyapakas, whereas adhyasa adhishthanam is vyapya. Adhyasa adhishthanatvam is vyapya, meaning adhyasa adhishthanatvam is in lesser places than indriya sanyuktatvam and vishayatvam. For example, ghata you are looking at, then indriya sanyuktatvam is there. Indriyas are connected with ghatapatadi. They are also vishayas. But there is no adhyasa adhishthanatvam. There is no adhyasa taking place there. We don't talk about adhyasa adhishthana there because there is no adhyasa there. But in rajju sarpasthala also there is indriya sanyuktatvam. There is also vishayatvam. But it is also adhyasa adhishthana. So adhyasa adhishthanatvam is in lesser places than indriya sanyuktatvam and vishayatvam. Thereby, indriya sanyuktatvam and vishayatvam are what? They are vyapaka dharmas, and adhyasa adhishthanatvam is a vyapya dharma. Dhumasthaniya. So yatra yatra dhuma bhavaha tatra tatra vanya bhava also. Now here, Purvapakshi further explains, tatra vyapaka bhavad atmanaha adhishthanatvam na sambhavati iti abhipretya ah pratyagatmani iti. So wherever dhuma is not there, there vanni is not there. So wherever vyapaka is not there, there, meaning vanni is not there. Vanni is the karana for dhuma. If vanni is there, dhuma may or may not be there. But dhuma being there, there has to be vanni. That being the case, if vanni itself is not there, vyapaka vanni is not there, then what will happen? Yatra yatra dhuma tatra tatra vanni. Now yatra yatra vanya bhava tatra tatra dhuma bhava. Wherever vanni is not there, there is dhuma bhava. Without vanni you cannot have smoke. Without fire you cannot have smoke. So here also vyapaka is indriya sanyuktatvam and vishayatvam, but wherever vishayatvam isn't there, there aparoksha adhyasa adhishthanatvam cannot be there. So vyapaka bhavad atmanaha adhishthanatvam na sambhavati, atma cannot become adhishthana. Here vyapaka bhava is indriya sanyuktatva bhava vishayatva bhavascha. So when indriya sanyuktatva isn't there and vishayatvam isn't there, then you cannot have vyapya, which is adhyasa adhishthanatvam. So na sambhavati, this is asambhava dosha here. Iti avipretya pratyagatmani iti, and therefore he said that pratyagatmani in the mula, pratyagatmani avishaye, it is not avishaya. व्यापक धर्म इज नॉट देयर इन प्रत्येगात्मा, विषयत्वम इज नॉट देयर, इंद्रिय संयुक्तत्वम इज नॉट पॉसिबल. सो व्यापकाभावाद व्याप्याभाव, व्याप्य इज अध्यास अधिष्ठानत्वम, अपरोक्ष अध्यास अनुष्ठानत्वम, दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. टीका फर्दर, प्रतीची पूर्णे इंद्रिया ग्राह्ये विषयस्य अहंकारादेः तद्धर्माणां च अध्यासः कथम इत्यर्थः. सो व्हाट इज कथम, ही इज नॉट आस्किंग हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल, इट इज अ रेटोरिक, मीन्स कैमुतिक न्यायेन असंभव इत्यर्थः, इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. प्रतीची पूर्णे इंद्रिया ग्राह्ये, सो इंद्रिय सन्निकर्ष इज नॉट पॉसिबल इन आत्मा, दैट काइंड ऑफ प्रत्येगात्मा विच इज पूर्ण, देर कैनॉट बी विषयत्वम और इंद्रिय ग्राह्यत्वम, इंद्रिय सन्निकर्ष इज नॉट पॉसिबल. सो इंद्रिय संयुक्तत्वम इज नॉट पॉसिबल, नो संयोग इज पॉसिबल. सो विषयस्य अहंकारादे, अहंकारादि इज अ विषय, हाउ कैन यू सुपर इम्पोज विषया एंड विषय धर्मास, इंद्रिय अहंकारा एंड अहंकारादि धर्मास ऑन दिस अविषय आत्मा च अध्यास कथम. सो तद्धर्माणां च अध्यास कथम, हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल, मीनिंग इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. उक्त व्याप्तिम आह, एंड व्हाट इज द व्याप्ति इन द मूल, सर्वो हि पूर्वावस्थितत्वम् इंद्रिय संयुक्तत्वम्. सो सर्वो हि इति, सर्वो हि, सॉरी, सर्वो हि इज सर्वो हि पूर्वावस्थित एव विषये विषयांतर मध्य स्थिति, दैट इज द व्याप्ति इन द मूल, इट इंडिकेट्स अ व्याप्ति. व्हाट इज द व्याप्ति देयर, पूर्वावस्थितत्वम् इंद्रिय संयुक्तत्वम्, द व्याप्ति दैट वी सॉ इन द टीका एज टू व्याख्या एज टू यत्र यत्र अपरोक्ष अध्यास अधिष्ठानत्वम् तत्र तत्र इंद्रिय संयुक्तत्वम् विषयत्वम् च इति. दिस इज अ व्याप्ति क्रिएटेड फ्रॉम द मूल इटसेल्फ. इन द मूल व्हाट वाज सेड, इट वाज सेड पूर्वावस्थितत्वम्, पूर्वावस्थितः विषय, पूर्वावस्थित विषय इज देर इन दी फ्रंट ऑफ योर आईज, मीनिंग इंद्रियाज आर कनेक्टेड, दैट्स व्हाट इट मीन्स. प्रत्यक्ष विषयत्व एंड इंद्रिय संयुक्तत्व इज इंडिकेटेड बाय विच वर्ड्स, इन दी मूल पूर्वावस्थित, पूर्वावस्थिते एव विषय, ऑन दैट विषय विच इज देर इन दी फ्रंट ऑफ युअर आईज. सो प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण सिद्ध, इट इज इंद्रिय गोचर, विषय ऑल्सो एंड इंद्रिय संयोग इज देर. Therefore, vyapaka dharmas have been borrowed from the mula. Puravasthitattvam in the mula is what? Indriya sanyuktattvam in the vyapti given earlier by the vyakhyanakara. And vishaye was said, so vishaye indicates vishayattvam in the puravasthita vishaya. Vishayattvam will be there. Therefore, vishayattvam is also vyapaka dharma. Nanu, आत्मनः अपि अधिष्ठानत्वार्थं विषयत्वादि विषयाति विषयात् विषयत्वादिकम् अस्तु इत्याह इत्यताह. सो नाउ दि पूर्वपक्षी एक्सपेक्ट्स दि सिद्धांति टू से, दिस इज सिद्धांति सेइंग दैट लेट इट बी सो, लेट व्हाट बी सो, ननु आत्मनः अपि अधिष्ठानत्वार्थं विषयत्वादिकम् अस्तु इत्यत आह युष्मदिति. And if at all Siddhanti were to answer to the Purvapakshi's objection to Atma not being a Vishaya, then he says, Atma can be an Adhishthana. How so? Atma is a Vishaya. So if at all you were to say, Purvapakshi says, if at all you, the Siddhanti, were to say, Vishayatvadikam astu, Vishayatvam means Vishayatvadikam, Adipadena, Indriya Grahyatvam. So Indriya Grahyatvam or Indriya संयुक्तत्वम अस्तु, विषयत्वम च अस्तु, लेट इट बी, लेट आत्मा हैव बोथ, व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम, लेट आत्मा बी अ विषय एंड हैव विषयत्व धर्म, लेट आत्मा बी इंद्रिय गोचर एंड हैव इंद्रिय संयुक्तत्व धर्म. इफ एट ऑल यू वेर टू से दैट, यू द सिद्धांति, फॉर व्हाट पर्पस, अधिष्ठानत्वार्थम, सो दैट इट बिकम्स एन अधिष्ठान, सो दैट यू गेट द व्याप्य धर्म ऑल्सो. इफ you make such a mistake, if you say such a thing, it will be a mistake. Why will it be a mistake? Ityataha yushmariti, and there in the mula, Purvapakshi has refuted an expected response also. As to Atma, if you say Atma is a Vishaya also at, has Indra Sannikarsha, that is not true. Yushmat Pratyopetasya cha Pratyagatmana Avishyatvam Tvameva Bravishi. You yourself have said that it cannot have Vishayatvam, it cannot be Indriya Gocharat. So having said that, now you cannot bring it back. Anyway, it is not possible. But if at all you were to say, you have yourself said it is not possible. Thereby, Tikakara says that this kind of a nadhyasa in the ahankaradi atma, ahankaradi sambandha is not possible, tadatme sambandha, and therefore dharma adhyasa is also not possible. Idam pratya anharasya pratyagatmanaha na chakshusha grihyate ityadi shrutim anusrutya tvam avishayatvam bravishi. And what you have said that Atma is not a Vishaya is in keeping with the Shruti. So if at all you counter it, then you will have Shruti Virodha, which you are not having right now. But you are having an impossibility of Adhishthanatvam in Atma. So Idam Pratyaya Anharasya Pratyagatmanaha That Pratyagatmanaha That Pratyagatma, that innermost self, which cannot be Idam Pratyaya Arha, which does not, you know, you don't cognize your own self as this. This is used for, Idam is used for something outside of you. You can talk about your Indriyas as Idam, Ahankara as Idam, Sharira as Idam, the outside objects as Idam, but you cannot talk about yourself as Idam. You don't say, you know, this person. When you say this person, it is someone else, not you. So Idam is what is meant in the Adhyasa Bhashya opening as Yushmat Pratyaya Gochara. And Yushmat has been used for Idam. Why? To show Atyanta Bheda, Atyanta Virodha. Atyanta Virodha between Asmat and Yushmat exist, therefore you have used Idam, because sometimes Idam is used, sometimes it is used. In language, there can be usage of Idam for yourselves also. So these are us. When you say these are us, then these means Idam. So there can be a confusion and these are us, therefore Idam has not been used and you have specifically used Yushmat, but by Yushmat you mean Idam. You mean something other than you. And therefore, it is not an object. You, the subject, cannot be the object. So, Idam Pratya Anharasya Pratyagatmana Na Chakshusha Grihyate. It is not an object. Why? Na Chakshusha Grihyate, says the Shruti, Ityadi Shruti Manusrutya. Following that particular Shruti, where Chakshu is an Upalakshana for others also, it covers all the Indriyas. Atma is not an object of any indriya. And also what? Yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasah. So it is not an object of vak or manas also. That kind of atma, how do you expect it to be an object at all? Tvam avishyatvam bravishi. In keeping with the Shruti, you have made the opening statement and you have established it. Now you say that it is an adhisthana, that is not possible because it is having no vishayatvam. Samprati, however, now what are you doing? Samprati, right avidanim, adhyasa lobhena. You want to establish adhyasa, your adhyasa vashya you want to establish, therefore you have lobha of adhyasa, your goal is to establish adhyasa. And you are using some tarka here and there, but it will have Shruti Virodha. It will have Virodha to your own statement. You will not be able to establish this. If at all you take this way out, then what will happen? Adhyasa lobhena vishyatvangi kare. If at all you end up establishing or accepting vishyatvam in pratyagatma, which is idam pratya anharaha, it is not Indriya Gochara, इट इज युष्मत् प्रत्यय गोचर, इट हैज विरोधा विद अस्मत् प्रत्यय, इट इज नॉट अ विषय, बट देर यू इफ एट ऑल यू एक्सेप्ट दैट इट इज अ विषय, देन व्हाट विल हैपन, श्रुति सिद्धांतयोर बाध स्याद इत्यर्थः, यू विल बी स्टैंडिंग opposite to Shruti, you will take the paksha which is viruddha to Shruti and your own Siddhanta. You will have compromised your own Advaita Siddhanta, you will have compromised Shruti also. Therefore, what? Vishayatvam cannot be accepted at all. It is not an object. Okay. This is the problem. What is the answer? Atmani adhyasa sambhavanam pratijanite uchyate iti. Now, Bhagavan Bhashyakara answers to this as to there is a possibility of adhyasa nonetheless. Possibility. We are not saying it is there definitely yet. This is a sambhavana bhashya. So, the purva pakshi who says it is impossible, he has to be made to accept that there is a possibility. You have seen the stages in jnana. Impossibility first. Then slowly, oh, possibility is there. Then you accept that yes, it is so. Then it is definitely so, and then finally Dhrida Nishchaya has to, it cannot be anything, but it has to be in this manner. That is jnana, that is jnana nishtha. Samshaya rahita jnanam. So how is there sambhavana also, how is there possibility? Because Shruti virodha has been shown, Siddhanta virodha has been shown. There Bhagavan Bhashyakara says uchyate iti, Bhashya उच्यते, response is what? Siddhanti says, न तावत अयम एकांतेन अविषयः, अयम आत्मा प्रत्यगात्मा एकांतेन अविषयः न, तावत is first of all, so first of all, let me give the basis for my argument, it is not that Atma is not a विषय at all, meaning it is not, we are not saying it is an object of indriya, but it is not that it cannot be known, it is not that it can not be known, it is not a vishaya is not true. And here vishayatvam is that, see, by vishayatvam what is meant, purvapakshi means object, but what is that object? Object of indriya. We are not saying that object of indriya, just because something is not an object of indriya does not mean it cannot be known. It is evident though. What we mean is that it is evident. Adhyasa is possible as long as the adhisthana, adhisthanatvam is possible, and adhisthanatvam is possible as long as there is evidence for adhisthana. There, it is evident. That is what we mean by avishaya na. It is not that it cannot be known. As long as it can be known in one way or the other, then it can become an adhisthana. There is a possibility that it can be an adhisthana for adhyasa. This much is our intention. Thereby, asmat pratyaya vishayatva, it is not a vishaya of idam pratyaya, but it is a vishaya of asmat pratyaya. I know myself as I. Who is that I? That I is not an object of Atma. The Atma itself is known as I. So there is, it is self-evident. Asmat pratyaya vishayatvat. Further we'll see in the Tika as to how it is. But it is anubhava siddha. Nobody says that I do not know myself. Everyone says I know myself. For right or wrong, adding on upadhis one may claim, but even without the upadhis one knows that I exist. I am a conscious entity, I am an existent entity. Sat and chit is very clear in the face of each and every prani, not only human beings. The prani does not know that it knows, but it knows that it exists, knows that it is conscious, it wants to live on. Therefore, asmat pratyaya vishaya atma definitely is. You are looking only as vishayatvam means idanta. That is not true. Vishayatvam can be ahanta also. You may have a misunderstanding translated as an object and subject, subject-object division you may have created in your mind, and this is how you are working with objections. But the fact is that asmat pratyaya vishaya atma is, it is known in the eye cognition. Each and every yushmat pratyaya is preceded with asmat pratyaya, because yushmat is not possible without asmat known first. You cannot say you unless you know that, you yourself know that I am this entity. You cannot say that ghatam pashyami without aham being there. Aham is hidden there. Even if you don't say aham, aham is known. By uttama purusha ekvachana pratyaya it is known. It is hidden within. In the pratyaya it is hidden, in each and every cognition it is hidden. In the language it is hidden, in the thought it is hidden. In each and every bodha it is hidden. Pratibodha viditam matam. That atma is your real self, which is known in each and every cognition. Even if you are not involved in the thinking process, as to the statement that you make, in the thinking process you think that, oh, I has not come in here, because I am not talking about myself, I am talking about someone else. So when you make a statement that devadattaha ghatam pashyati, there also you are there. How are you there? Oh, I am not there in the sentence. Devadatta is not me. Ghata is not me. Pashyati kriya is not me. How is eye cognition known there? It is known because you are making the statement. You cannot make the statement unless you are there. And the person who makes the statement knows that he is there. So you who is talking about Devadatta and his pashyana kriya with ghata being a karma, you making the statement exist. You know that you exist. You know that you are conscious. So how have you missed yourself while making that statement of Devadatta ghatam pashyati? You have no possibility of missing yourself, but you have missed it. Because you are involved in analyzing Devadatta and his ghata and the pashyana kriya, pashyati kriya, darshana kriya. So that pashyati kriya has taken you away, Devadatta has taken you away, the karma has taken you away, ghata has taken you away, but you are there nonetheless, known to yourself as asmat pratyaya vishaya. Therefore, na tavad ayam pratyagatma ekantena avishayaha, meaning vishayatvam is possibly not the kind of vishayatvam that you mean as to indriya gochara and puravastita ityadi what you have meant. That kind of vishayatvam is not there. We agree. Satyam. However, vishayatvam itself is not there. That cannot be argued. So, asmat pratyaya vishayatvam is there. Yushmat pratyaya vishayatvam is not there. There, why so? Aparokshatvaccha. Without any intervening karana, you know that you are there. So, aparokshatvaccha. Pratyagatma prasiddhehe. By aparokshatvam, I know that I am. When I wake up in the morning, I know I am. In the very moment of waking up, I know that I exist. I am conscious. Therefore, pratyagatma prasiddhi is there. Each and every one knows that I exist. I am conscious. Now, further, what did you say? You said that adhyasa is possible only when it is puravastita vishaya. That is also not true. Nachayam asti niyamaha. There is no such rule which you argue. You, the Purvapakshi, insist that there is a rule that adhyasa is possible in cases where you have object right in front of your eyes. So, nacha ayam asti niyamaha. What is the niyama you quoted, or as though a rule you quoted? Puravastita eva vishaya vishayantaram adhyasitavyam miti. Adhyasa is possible only unto that vishaya which is right in front of your eyes. the other Vishaya can be superimposed along with its dharma only on Vishaya which is in front of your eyes is available for cognition through the Indriyas. That is not true. Why? Where is the example for Adhyasa on a Vishaya which is not there in, which is not Pratyaksha Pramana Siddha? Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, Apratyakshe api hyakashe balaha talamalinatadi adhyasyanti. He says, why those who are tarkavitpanna, why talk about them? Even talk about kids. He says, balaha. In fact, balaha eva, those who do not know, those who are not tarkakushala, they superimpose the dome shape on akasha, which is not pratyaksha siddha. Akasha is not accepted by Vedantins as pratyaksha pramana siddha. It is there, it is known, but not the way ghatapatadi are known. So, apratyaksha, apratyakshe akashe hi. Indeed, even on an apratyaksha akasha, tala malinatadi, tala is the dome shape. We say the sky is dome shape. General usage is there. As children, we used to say, as look at the sky, dome shape. And, oh, the space also, sky and space, both meanings are applicable here in akasha. What you look at, when you look at the sky is, you are looking at space, antariksha. So, in that akasha, dome shape, on that akasha, dome shape is superimposed. It does not have tala shape at all. What about malinatvam? Does it have malinatvam? Malinatvam is also not possible. If you keep something in space, that space is not tainted by that dirt. The dust or dirt does not affect the space. The stinking garlic in a pot is not affecting the space of the pot. It affects the particles of the wall of the pot, particles of the pot. It gets mixed up there, but not with space. Otherwise, when you move the pot, then still the space where the pot was kept earlier, that would become stinky. It doesn't. Or fragrant, whatever it is. Or dusty. The dust and dirt in the space is not really affecting the space. But we say that the space is dusty. The space is not dusty. This area is dusty. When you say this area is not clean, we mean the space, which is not right. The space is not affected at all. So what is that? That is adhyasa. That space which is apratyaksha, it is not a vishaya of pratyaksha pramana. There also adhyasa is possible. Therefore, you cannot make a rule. You cannot state a rule as though a rule as to sarvohi puravasthite eva vishaye vishayantara madhyasthiti. You have made it as though a rule. Oh, everyone does it. Everyone has only this kind of eva. You have used evakara. That kind of evakara cannot be used. There is no such rule. So, with this example, your rule is broken. Evam aviruddha pratyagatmanyapi anatma adhyasa. Therefore, there is no virodha to adhyasa being possible in atma of anatma and anatma dharma. There is no asambhavana there. That impossibility that you express isn't there. Meaning, it can be possible. Now, how is it possible? That has to be looked into. Further in the vyakhya, उच्यते इति अधिष्ठान आरोप्येहो एकस्मिन् ज्ञाने भासमानत्व मात्रम अध्यास व्यापकम्. सो व्हाट इज द व्यापक धर्म हियर? दिस विषयत्वम एंड इंद्रिय सन्निकर्षत्वम और इंद्रिय what was used earlier as Indriya Sanyuktattvam. So, Indriya Sanyuktattvam, their Vyapti is what? Yatra Aparoksha Adhyas Adhisthanattvam Tatra Tatra Indriya Sanyuktattvam Vishayattvam Chaiti. That kind of Vyapti is not possible. What is the Vyapaka Dharma there? Indriya Sanyuktattvam and Vishayattvam in your Vyapti that you have expressed as though a rule. That's the Vyapti. That is not right. What is the Vyapti there? What is the Vyapaka? It is not Indriya Sanyuktattvam or Vishayattvam. Wherever there is Adhisthanattvam, Indriya Sanyuktattvam and Vishayattvam is not expected. What is the Vyapaka Dharma? Vyapaka Dharma is सूच्यते अधिष्ठान आरोप्येहो एकस्मिन् ज्ञाने भासमानत्व मात्रम्. Only that much is needed. No विषयत्वम् is necessary. No इंद्रिय संयुक्तत्वम् is necessary. What is necessary though? अधिष्ठान आरोप्येहो of the अधिष्ठान and आरोप्य एकस्मिन् ज्ञाने भासमानत्व मात्रम्. What is needed is in one single unit of jnana, in one single unit of knowledge, both should be evident. What should be evident? Adhisthana should be evident, meaning idantva of shukti should be evident, and aropya, rajata, rajatattvam should be evident. Now, rajata known and idanta known, one can put it together in one jnana as idam rajatam. That much, all that is expected is that much. That is all that is expected. Bhasam, is idantva known in shukti rajata sthala first? Yes. Puropakshi anyway does not have objection there. But the vyapaka dharma should be explained in the example first. When I say that this much is expected in atma to become adhyasa adhisthana, aparoksha, Adhyasa Adhisthana, I need to explain that in the example also. Because Vyapaka Dharmas, in the Vyapti that Purvapakshi have brought in, those are not there. Assuming that those are not there. Indriya Sanyuktattvam anyway is not there. Vishayattvam, we have shown that it is not Idam Pratyay Vishayattvam, but Aham Pratyay Vishayattvam. That is the answer in keeping with the Vyapti words as used by Bhagavan Bhashyakara. Now the Vyakhyanakara has a Purvapakshi who has detailed the Vyapti as Vyapaka Dharmas being Indriya Sanyuktattvam and Vishayattvam. So now looking at Indriya Vishayattvam also, that is not expected. And we say Vishayattvam is also not expected the way you intend. We can show it by another Vyapaka Dharma. What is that? Adhisthana Aropyayo Ekasmin Jnane Bhasamanattvam. In a single unit of knowledge, in Shukti Rajata Stala, is the Idantva of the Shukti known? Adhisthana known. It is known. Idantva is known. In that jnana it is there. Rajata, is it known? Rajata is also known. So Aropya is also known. In the Idam Rajata jnana it is known. That itself is Adhyasa. Bhasamanatva Matram Adhyasa Vyapakam. That is Vyapakatvam. So what will you say? Yatra yatra adhisthana aropyayoho ekasmin jnane bhasamanatvam tatra tatra adhisthana aparoksha tatra tatra aparoksha adhisthana aparoksha adhyasa adhisthanatvam, sorry, tatra tatra aparoksha adhyasa adhisthanatvam. That much is the vyapaka dharma. Wherever the adhisthana and aropya can be known in a single unit of knowledge, it is evident in a single unit of knowledge, there adhyasa adhisthanatvam is there. Is possible at least. That much we have to say. In fact, in Vyapti, it will be there. Other way around, rather. Yatra yatra adhisthana. So, we have to put it in this same frame. So, let me correct it. I made a mistake there. So, yatra yatra aparoksha adhyasa adhisthanatvam. This is the vyapya. Tatra tatra indriya sanyukta vishayatvam chaiti. This has to be dropped and replaced with what? It has to be replaced with adhisthana aropyo ekasmin jnane bhasamanatvam. Matra is there. We can say matram also. Or we can say adhisthana दिस भासमानत्वम. सो वील से यत्र यत्र अपरोक्ष अध्यास अधिष्ठानत्वम तत्र तत्र अधिष्ठान आरोप्य हो एकस्मिन् ज्ञाने भासमानत्वम. दिस इज द व्याप्ति, दिस इज द राइट व्याप्ति, सेज द सिद्धांति. सो व्हाट विल दिस मीन? वेर एवर यू से दैट देर इज अध्यास, अपरोक्ष अध्यास इन द एग्जाम्प्लीफाइड इन द आत्मा, देर आत्मा इज इट नोन, आत्मा इज नोन हाउ? अस्मत् प्रत्यय विषय गोचर, अस्मत् प्रत्यय गोचर इज आत्मे, अस्मत् प्रत्यय विषय. सो आत्मा इज अस्मत् प्रत्यय विषय, इट इज ऑल्सो प्रसिद्ध. As said earlier, it is also prasiddha. Everyone knows oneself in whichever way. Now this will be shown in two ways. How one exactly knows, that will be shown. So that much is there. Adhishthana is known and Atma Adhishthana is known. Aropya is also known. Ahankara is also known. When you say aham, aham asmi bho ho, just a statement, aham asmi, aham, aham, aham asmi. If someone asks you, knock on the door. So samanya napunsakam, someone says, Kim, ask from inside, Kim, meaning who is there? It can be asked kaha also, ka also, but the linga is not known. Somebody just knocks on the door, so samanya napunsakam. So someone within the house asks, who is it? How does he ask? Kim. And then you say, aham asmi bho, aham asmi, aham, aham. So there when you say aham, do you know that you exist? Definitely, even if you don't say asmi, when you just say aham, do you know that you exist? Asmi is included there. By the usage, aham, you don't, won't say aham asti. Even if say asti also, wrong usage also will mean bhu sattayam. It will show that satta is known to you. So, I, the expression I itself shows that atma is known. For right or wrong, it is known. We are not claiming that the Atmajnana is there, Brahmajnana is there. We are just saying I is known as I. Atma, Pratyagatma, existence is known. Satta and Chitta is known. That is Swarupa of Atma. Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. Therefore, that Atma is not lost on you. Additional noise may be there. And that is what we are saying, it is Adhyasa. So, Adhishthana is known. Aropya is also there in the same cognition. When you say I, there if nothing else, you do, even if you don't express aham praveenaha, you don't make that statement that I am this man, I have a name and form. Although you don't make that statement, still that is also there in your mind. If nothing else, that individuality is there, because aham means individual. So that individuality is also come up as a baggage, but because individuality has come up does not mean that the content is missing. The content is there. Just because the baggage is there, the content cannot be seen to be missing. I see the bag, I don't see the content, but content is known as well to me. I am the carrier of the bag. So I who carry my ahankara, when I make the statement aham, the satta and chitta is not lost on me. That is right in my expression, it is there. Each and every expression. Therefore, adhishthana aropyo ekasmin jnane bhasamanatvam is definitely there. That being so, vyapaka dharmasya bhavat. Adhyasa vyapakasya bhavat. Adhyasa adhishthanatvam api sambhavati. So, in that expression itself, there is a possibility of, see, one who is knocking on the door can be an ajnani also, jnani also. Jnani is not having this adhyasa. Not having this adhyasa means he does not know himself as an individual all the times. So he can have jnana there as well. He can, while knocking on the door also, he may be having nishta, atma nishta, brahma nishta. There adhyasa is not there. There the vikshepa is not real. Although vikshepa is there, it is not real because avarna has gone away. In that kind of a case, adhyasa is not there, but adhyasa adhishthanatvam is possible, is what we want to show, as to that person who is knocking on the door can be an ajnani, and more likely he is. There, आत्मा हैज बिकम एन अधिष्ठान फॉर आरोप्य जीवत्व भाव अहंकारादि अध्यासा इज देर एंड देर धर्माज आर ऑल्सो अध्यस्त. Why? Because both are known in the same unit of knowledge. That itself is sufficient for adhyasa to take place. That is the sambhavana bhashya here. Tachya. Tachya kim? Ekasmin jnane adhisthana aropyayoho bhasamanatva matram. Tachya adhyasa vyapakam. So that adhyasa vyapakam tachya. भान प्रयुक्त संशय निवृत्त्यादि फलभाक्त्वम् तदेव भान भिन्नत्व घटितं विषयत्वम् तन्न व्यापकं गौरवाद् इति मत्वा आहनतावद्दिति. दिस इज अ लिटिल कॉम्प्लेक्स नाउ. इट गेट्स अ लिटिल कॉम्प्लेक्स बट वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज द इंटेंशन बिहाइंड दिस. नाउ लेट्स लुक एट इंटरप्रिटेशंस. व्हाट इज दिस अध्यास व्यापकम्? What is the vyapaka dharma needed for adhyasa? It is the adhisthana and aropya, the substratum and the superimposed, being cognized in the same knowledge, ekasmin jnane. Bhasamanatvam is being cognized. Matram, that much only is the vyapaka dharma. Now, in the For the jnani also it is available, for najnani also it is available. So it is in more places than where adhyasa takes place, so it is a vyapaka dharma. More places than where there is adhyasa. So now, tachya vyapakam, that vyapakam is what? Bhana prayukta samshe nivrityadi phalabhaktvam. Tachya bhasamanatvam. तच्च व्यापकम् विच इज व्यापक भासमानत्वम् भासमानत्वम् मात्रम् सो वी विल से भासमानत्वम् राइट नाउ द कॉग्निशन विच इज अवेलेबल ऑफ बोथ द अधिष्ठान एंड आरोप्य इन द सेम नॉलेज व्हाट इज दैट भासमानत्वम् दैट इज एक्सप्लेन्ड फर्दर एज भान प्रयुक्त संशय निवृत्त्यादि फलभाक्त्वम् सो समासा इज उपपद तत्पुरुष फलभाक्त्वम् इज व्हाट फलम भजते इति फलभाक तस्य भाव फलभाक्त्वम् सो फलभाक्त्वम् व्हाट इज दी फल भान प्रयुक्त संशय देर इज अ संशय व्हाट इज संशय अहम मनुष्यो वा न वा Not for everyone, but is there a samshaya? Is there a samshaya that I am there or not? Whether I am a manushya or not, one may wake up and think from a nightmare where one saw oneself as something else. But bhana prayukta samshaya nivritya adi phala bhakto. What is the phala when you have? अहम प्रत्यय व्हेन यू से आई व्हाट डू यू नो योरसेल्फ एज समथिंग बट यू नो योरसेल्फ सो देर इज नो संशय व्हाट काइंड ऑफ संशय अहम अस्मी वा न वा दैट काइंड ऑफ संशय इफ एट ऑल इट इज देर दैट गोज अवे व्हाट डज इट गो बाय अहम अस्मी I know that I am there. So someone asks you, oh, are you there or are you not there? What do you know? You cannot have that confusion. Someone may ask, you know, if somebody, you knock on the door, rather someone knocks on the door, you are inside. And the person asks, oh, are you there? Oh, Devadatta, are you there at home? You don't have a doubt. That person may have a doubt whether you are there or not. But you know yourself that you are there. So asti bhati, definitely priya also. Thereby bhana prayukta, one who is endowed with this bhana, aham asmi iti, tena samshaya nivritti bhavati eva. Whatever samshaya is there regarding, there is no samshaya possible itself as to your being there or not being there. So aham, or even if you say what devadattah ghatam pashyati, there also in the darshana kriya that you talk about of samadhar karta, of samadhar karma, in that darshana kriya also you are there because you know you exist. If someone, if you may have a samshaya, oh, I am talking about someone else, where am I talking about myself, but you are there, you don't have a doubt there. Therefore samshaya nivrityadi phalabhaktvam is there in what, that bhasamanatvam itself, where you are talking about anything else also, you know that you exist, therefore there is no doubt about yourself. Tadeva bhana bhinnatva ghatitam vishayatvam. So some explain this itself. What is that? Vishayatvam. Atma cannot be vishaya. That itself is vishayatvam of atma. Why so? Bhana bhinnatva. Is it different from the bhana which is taking place? For example, in the darshana kriya of devadatta, devadatta ghatam pashyati. Ghata is karma. Darshana kriya is going on. How do you know darshana kriya? By pashyati. Pashyati kriya or darshana kriya. Earlier I said pashyana kriya, not pashyana kriya. Pashyan is the sananta form. So ludanta form will be darshana kriya. Because we need bhavi vipatti. So there will be, the drish dhatu will come back. It will not take pashya adesha. Pashya adesha it will not take. So you will have darshana kriya. So the darshana kriya or the pashyati kriya by ikstipo dhatu nirdeshe, pashyati kriya also, you can talk about the dhatu itself as pashyati. So there devadattaha ghatam pashyati, there also the kriya which is taking place, darshana kriya, is the karma ghata different from the kriya? It is. Therefore it is vishaya. So what will we say? The kriya is darshana kriya. Darshana kriyayaha vishayaha kaha. That vishaya is ghataha. So ghata is darshana kriya vishaya. That darshana kriya vishaya is different from the darshana. Similarly, here bhana is taking place. When you say bhasamanatvam, bhasamanatvam bhanam, bhana is taking place. Bhana of what? Adhishthana and aropya. Adhishthana happens to be atma. How can it be atma here? Because we are talking about a possibility. So adhishthana, aropya are known in ekasmin jnana. They are known in eka jnana. So ekasmin jnane bhasamanatvam. Bhasamanatvam is bhanatvam. Bhana. Bhana is taking place. That bhana is like a kriya. Vyakrana kriya. So it's a vyakrana kriya because it's a dhatu. It is from the dhatu. Therefore, that bhana taking place, just like darshana kriya taking place, ghata being different from darshana, ghata is a vishaya. And here also bhana bhinnatvam. So ghata is what? Darshana kriya bhinna. So ghata has ghatatva, ghata also has darshana kriya bhinnatvam. Darshana bhinnatvam is there. Similarly, here bhana, if you take it as kriya, then bhasamanatvam which is there, which we are talking about, that bhana bhinnatva ghatitam vishayatvam will be there. Bhana bhinnatva ghatita vishayatvam should be accepted in atma. Tanna vyapakam. This is some of them say, some opine that vishayatva itself, you know, which is devised. You devise this vishayatvam from the difference with cognition. There is a cognition taking place. And the vishayatvam has to be accepted in atma because it is different from cognition itself. Atma is not the cognition. Atma is different from the bhana, and thereby vishayatva can be devised from it. Tanna vyapakam, but then that is not said to be vyapaka. Why? Because gauravad. It is not a vyapaka dharma. We need not talk about that and bring in the possibility of adhyasa in the vyapti. Why? Because gaurava dosha is there. When you can take a simpler way out, then you take a simpler way out. So if you can, for example, you can make so many things as vyapaka dharmas, but what do you take as vyapaka dharma? The bare minimum which is necessary. So yatra yatra dhuma tatra tatra vannihi. Vanni is vyapaka dharma vannitva. Vanni is being talked about there. It is more vyapaka. You don't need to bring in so many things. There will be gaurava dosha. So when you can do with only adhisthana aropya ekasmin jnane bhasamanattvam, bhasamanattvam matra can be done, can be used as vyapaka dharma to establish, then why do you need other things? You don't need to explain that and then bring this adhisthana as being different from bhasa meaning bhana, bhasamana meaning from the bhana which is taking place. The adhisthana is different, therefore it is a vishaya, therefore it has vishayatvam, and therefore that vishayatva is a vyapaka dharma. All this is gaurava. Too convoluted. So what do? You use just simple thing as adhisthana aropyo ekasmin jnane bhasamanatvam. Bhasamanatvam matram, that itself is vyapaka dharma, and thereby yatra yatra aparoksha adhyasa adhisthanatvam tatra tatra adhisthana aropyo ekasmin jnane bhasamanatvam. That much is the vyapti, and that is indicated by Bhagavan Bhashyakara when he says na tavat अयम एकांतेन, अयम आत्मा प्रत्युगात्मा एकांतेन अविषय इति न. इट इज नॉट सो. वाई? अस्मत् प्रत्यय विषयत्वात् अपरोक्षत्वाच्च प्रत्युगात्म प्रसिद्धेः. देर इज डेफिनेटली आत्मा नोन इन अस्मत् प्रत्यय एज अ विषय इटसेल्फ, यू कैन टेक इट, एंड अपरोक्ष ऑल्सो, बोथ वेज. इट इज नोन बाय इटसेल्फ. Swayam prakashatvam, aparokshatvam, swayam prakashatvam here in the case of atma. Also what? In the aham pratyaya, there is a vritti. In the vritti, there is pratibimba. Aham, atma pratibimba is there, which is known as the jiva bhava. Jiva bhava is there when brahmatma reflects off, so to say. By pratibimba vada, pratibimba is there in the antakkarana. Antakkarana vritti is there now. Antakkarana itself modifies in the form of vritti. What kind of vritti? Aham pratyaya. That eye cognition which takes place even when you talk about devadattaha ghatam pashyati, aham is known. Or if nothing else, why go thus far? Only take a simple thing as aham. When you say aham, I am there, I, you make a statement every time we talk about ourselves. We have a lot of ego. Most of us talk about, even not only an egoistic person talks about oneself, even a person with less ego. Without ego, you cannot survive. You have some kind of an individuality. You don't let people walk over you. Even if you let people walk over you, you don't care also. Still, there is some ego. Aham is there. It is known. And in that asmat pratyaya, which is antakkarana vritti, there is a pratibimba. Pratibimba is there in avidya. That avidya manifests as antakkarana. So karana sharira is manifested as sukshma sharira, which is antakkarana. Antakkarana is a part of that. So the pratibimba continues in the antakkarana. Antakkarana takes vritti, forms of vrittis, ghatakara vritti, patakara vritti. But in that there is also ahamakara vritti. As a pramata, there is a vritti, because when you say ghata is a vishaya, it is a vishaya for you. So when you become the subject of that object, that time also antakkarana has a ahamakara vritti. In that ahamakara, aham pratyaya, atma is pratibimbita. So pratibimba shows you your bimbatva. Through pratibimba, you know that I exist. The bimba is there. Without bimba, bimbam vina, pratibimba na sambhavati. So pratibimba is there. Why is pratibimba there? Because bimba atma is there. Therefore also, aham is known. Atma is known in aham. And aparokshatvacha, it is known by itself. Without the antakkarna vritti also, you are there. You are there. When the antakrana vritti goes, you don't cease to be, you are there. In nidra vritti you are there, in samadhi vritti you are there, in nirvikalpaka samadhi or the yogis, chitta vritti, nirodha rupa samadhi also you are there. And known to be there. Why? Self-evident. Swayam prakashatvat. Alupta druk. that kind of a Upanishad. Upanishad Atma, Upanishad Purusha, you are. So you are known. Now here, additional information is there for an Ajnani. But Ajnani does not miss upon one's Atma Swarupa. Thereby, Na Tavadditi. And then further, Ayam Atma Niyamena Avishaya Na Bhavati, we'll see in the next part. यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजां कमनन्त सुखाकृतिम्. एनी क्वेश्चंस? विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. नमस्ते.
नमस्ते गुरु.
नमस्ते.